So good evening everyone. Welcome to my UCLA YouTube session. So welcome you all. How are you guys? Yes, this is Syed Gauss, your biology educator. He is on YouTube now. Students. So waiting for the students to join. So students, as you all know, Sun Academy came up with the new programs, new plans at PLUS. So in this PLUS, you can get complete syllabus get covered. You can get tips and tricks by top educators. And you can get topic wise practice questions. And even you can get full length mock tests. So all they are just at 1 month at the rate of 2250 rupees. So you can use the code of GauSLive, GHOUSELIVE. So you can use the 10% off in the PLUS subscription. Students, not only 1 month plan, you can have on 6 months and 12 months plan. So 6 months, you can see here, this is only for new subscribers. Then 6 months plan, you can get at the rate of 1688 per month, and 12 month plan, you can get 1031 per month. So in this, what you all get here is, you will get premium content at very affordable price. You can get structured live courses, dedicated live doubt clearing sessions. You can get quizzes at regular intervals of time for self-analysis. You will have batches for complete preparation. You can have test series for DPPs, full-length marks, etc. with analysis. And students, the most important point is what here? Single subscription, you can get unlimited access. So you can attend all the educators' classes which you are suitable for. So for all this, you can use the code of GauSLive, GHOUSELIVE. So all of they are capital without space. So you'll get 10% off in PLUS subscription. You can get 10% off in PLUS subscription. So students, today topic is RNA interference. So let me start. Students, you can post your doubts in the live chat box so that we'll discuss. So this, as per NCERT, comes in one of the topic of biotechnology application. Just guess, I'm keeping you this in front of you. Yes, now. Yes, guys, welcome you all to this YouTube session again. Yes, so we are going to talk about nematode resistance plants. So when you're talking about nematode resistance plants, students, as you all know that several nematodes, okay, parasitized a wide variety of plants and animals, including human beings. So they are parasites, no? So any parasite, no? They can infect the plants, animals, as well as the humans also. Now, you can observe the second point, guys, here. a nematode called Melodigne incognitia. So nematode called Melodigne incognitia infects the root of tobacco plants and causes great reduction in yield. So students, you can see the picture here. Okay, so this is called root knotting. So root knots. So the nematode called Melodigne incognitia, which infects the roots of tobacco plant, and it is causing a great loss to the farmer. Why it will be the great loss to the farmers, guys? Yes, because yield will get reduced, na? Yes. You can see the picture of Melodigne incognitia on the screen. So that will be responsible for root knot disease. That will be responsible for which disease, guys? Root nodule disease. So keep in mind. So Melodigne incognitia is it platy helminthes or nematy helminthes? Guys, please mention in your comment box, live chat box. Hello all. Okay, so Melodigne incognitia, is it parasite? Okay, no, parasite only. Is it belongs to platy helminthes or nematy helminthes? Platy helminthes or nematy helminthes? Tell me, guys, fatafat. Waiting for the comment box. Fast, tell me here. Yes. Yes, waiting for your answer, students. Super. What is the answer here? Yes, it is a nematy helminthes. Okay, nothing but nematode. Nematy helminthes, nothing but what, guys? Nematode. Super, now. Yes, now Melodigne incognitia causes which disease? Root knot disease. In which plant? In which plant? Tobacco plants. In which plant, guys? Tobacco plants. So now we'll start with RNA interference technology. Can you know the RNA interference technology? So RNA interference technology, short, takes place in all eukaryotic organism as a method of cellular defense, students. This is very, very, very important. So RNAi, in short, takes place in all eukaryotic organism as a method of which defense, guys? Cellular defense. Now, a defense response that is mediated by cells. A defense response that is mediated by cells. So RNA interference technology, which is a defense mechanism present in all eukaryotic organisms, mediated by cells. Now you see here, this method involves the silencing of a specific mRNA. This method involves silencing of a specific mRNA due to complementary RNA molecule that binds and prevents the translation of mRNA. Prevents what, guys? Translation of mRNA. Okay, so now let me show you here. Let me take a whiteboard, guys. Okay, let me take a whiteboard here. Okay, now the student is taking whiteboard now. Yes, now. So now let me start with RNA interference here. So first I will teach you on the whiteboard, then we'll go for PPT, students, okay? So that you can understand the concept better. So now RNA interference, you know, it is a method of cellular defense.
in all eukaryotes, it's a method of cellular defense. In all eukaryotes, cellular defense. In all eukaryotes, in all eukaryotes. Now, student, here you see any parasite which injects over DNA, na? Anything, any parasite injects over DNA. So, in the host, now this DNA undergoes what transcription? This DNA undergoes what, guys? Transcription, and forms what it is? mRNA. It forms what, students? mRNA. So, towards this, you know, so by using some vectors, we can introduce the another mRNA. This is nothing but what? Complementary RNA. Complementary RNA. You can add either through agrobacterium, or you can use retrovirus. So retroviruses have which are genetic material, you know, RNA as genetic material, right? So now, students, this mRNA and this complementary RNA, when you add it, now it is going to form what now? Being the complementary nature, this is going to form what? Yes, dsRNA. Being complementary in nature, it is going to form dsRNA. So what is dsRNA, students? Double-stranded RNA. DS are nothing but what? Double-stranded RNA. So now, as soon as this double-stranded RNA forms, okay, then you know which proteins are going to identify this. Okay, this is unnatural, right? This is unnatural. It should not be there. So, next process. What is the next process here? Translation will be prevented. So, what is the next process, guys? Translation will be prevented. So, how translation will be prevented? As you know, if gene has to express, right? So, the gene, suppose gene is there. Nothing but DNA, right? It has to form mRNA. Then this mRNA is going to form what? Protein, right? As you all know. So, first process is called what? Transcription process. Second process is what? Translation process. So, till this, no, we are not allowing this process. We are not allowing this process. Okay. Welcome you all, guys, who are joining right now. So, very important topic it is. So, many students, they feel it is a difficult, guys. So, keep focus on this. This topic is going to become very, very, very simple. You can also share this video to your friends so that everyone will get benefited there. So, now, immediately, guys, what happened? No? A protein called dicer will bind. A protein called which will bind, guys? Yes, the protein called what? Dicer will bind. Dicer means what? It is a deoxy, you know, it is a cleaving enzyme. Simply, I am telling it, okay? Cleaving enzyme means what? It kills what? It breaks the RNA. Now, it breaks the RNA. Breaks dsRNA into small pieces. So what is this called? Small pieces called siRNA. What are these small pieces, guys? Let me know quick. You can mention you on your comment box. siRNA nothing but what? Small interfering RNA. Small interfering RNA. So let me repeat here. Once any parasite infects, means it injects DNA. So naturally transcription technique forms mRNA. So what we are doing is, in antisense RNA technology or RNA interference technology or gene silencing technology, all these different names, okay? This is also called gene silencing, right? So what we will do is we will add the complementary RNA. So once you add the complementary RNA, it is going to form dsRNA. It is going to form what? dsRNA. As you all know, dsRNA is unnatural. Okay, so immediately dicer is a protein, okay, that is going to bind to the double strand RNA, and it breaks into small RNA. So this is nothing but what? siRNAs. So to these siRNAs, yes, students, any idea?
another complex called RISC will bind. Risc. Okay, what is RISC? Please write down, student. RNA induced silencing complex. RNA induced silencing complex, nothing but what, students? Risc. So RNA induced silencing complex, nothing but what? Risc. So what it will do? It degrades RNA. So it degrades what now? RNA. What is present here? So if it degrades RNA, what is the next step? Translation will be prevented. So yes, now this mechanism is also called as gene silencing mechanism or antisense RNA technology, or antisense RNA technology. Students, you all understand now? Please, I'll give a time to you. Please write down. Take a notebook and please copy it. So, when any host injects this DNA, it is going to form RNA, right? This RNA, it is going to be added by the complementary RNA. Okay, then it forms dsRNA. To this dsRNA, which will bind? Dicer will bind. What dicer will do? It forms siRNA. What siRNA will do, you know? To this, which proteins will bind? Risc proteins will bind. And it prevents the translation process. And it prevents which process, students? Translation process. Now let me take now. Now once again you see. Simple step I will write here. Simple steps. You take Melodina incognita. Okay. Melodina incognita. Okay. It infects which plant? Root nodule. Okay. Root. In the root it injects what? DNA, right? Then what we will add, what will happen next to this? It forms mRNA naturally. If DNA forms a protein, then it causes root nodule disease, right? Okay, now do this mRNA. We are going to make what? We are going to add complementary RNA. We are going to add what, guys? Complementary RNA. So if you add complementary RNA, it is going to form what? dsRNA. You know, double strand RNA, DS, write down please. Double stranded RNA. Then, if you add double strand RNA, you know, guys, what happens? Next step is what? Dicer will bind. So, dicer is going to form what? siRNA. So, to this siRNA, what is going to bind? RISC will bind. So what RISC will do? It degrades mRNA and it prevents translation. Please write down now fast. Fodafat. So that's the reason why this is also called as, yes, this is also called as which mechanism? Gene silencing mechanism or gene silencing or antisense RNA technology. Okay. Or RNA interference technology, ORR,
RNA interference technology, or of antisense RNA technology. Students, you can post your doubts in the comment box. Fast. You can see, students, now. You can post your doubts in the comment box, guys. So, what is siRNA? Small interfering RNA, it's nothing but siRNA. What is RISC? RNA induced silencing complex. You can post your doubts in the live chat box. Last 5 minutes, we can discuss all your doubts regarding this concept. So, waiting for your doubts. Thank you. Students, you can post in your live box so that we can discuss your doubts. So you can follow me on Unacademy KSET app. So there you can get everyday mock tests, free live sessions, quizzes, everything you'll get it there. So if you're watching this class for the first time, you can follow me on Unacademy KSET app. Students, you can ask your doubts in the comment section first. Hey students, so hope you got clarity on this topic. Okay students, so tomorrow again we'll meet the same time in YouTube. So till the time, thank you all. Bye bye.